How much did she cost, you know? Was she cheap?
What was the hourly rate? Was that?
Maybe 28万4万.
I could do that. What did she do?
He's writing this down. He's actually written it down.
Everybody, welcome back to Small Talk Japan. On this show, we talk about all things Japan in English. My name is Michi, and these are my co-hosts.
Natsuki.
And Alex.
And today we're going to talk about, is Japanese TV, I forgot the title, Golden Nugget or Steaming Crap. What was the title?
Golden Nugget.
I forgot what the title
is. What is Golden Nugget?
Is it a Golden Nugget in a pile of steaming crap?
It could be.
Yeah.
That is an option. What's the actual title to this show?
Japanese TV, golden entertainment or steaming garbage?
Yeah, I wanted to say golden nugget, steaming pile of shit, but I figured if you wrote bad words in the title, it would get poo-pooed by YouTube.
Literally.
Yes. So let's talk about this, guys. So I don't know who I want to throw it to first. Natsuki, how do you like Japanese TV?
Love it. Love it because I'm Japanese.
But that doesn't mean shit. Like, just because you're Japanese, like, I don't know.
But some of them are shit, but some of them are good.
Some of them are all shit. I'm sorry.
Are shit.
Alex, in a what, like, in a few word answer before we get into the details of it, how do you feel about Japanese TV?
Banal.
Banal?
What is banal? Is that English word?
Yeah, it's an English word.
Okay.
It means, like, what would you say? Pointless and
pointless
childish.
And harmless and stupid.
Yeah.
Shut up.
Generally, yeah, I'm not a fan, to be honest.
Mm. Natsuki, let's start off with the positives. What do you like about Japanese TV? It's in Japanese, okay, so that's easy.
Yeah, it's in Japanese.
What else do you like about it?
I don't know. I mean, it's some of them are fun to watch, you know.
So are you speaking of like variety TV shows?
Sure, sometimes I watch dramas.
I thought you were going to go with Doraemon there for a second.
No way. Yeah, I really liked it when I was little. Yeah, Doraemon was my favorite.
Okay. Like, what's the last drama you actually watched and thought was good?
The one that you criticized.
Before the show?
Yeah, before the show.
What's it called again?
Nigeru wa...
Hajida ga nantoka.
Yeah, I liked it, but I cannot name it. Nigeru wa Hajida ga yakunitatsu.
Yakunitatsu.
How can you like a show but not know what the name
because
is?
Because we made the title shorter and we call it Nigehaji.
Nigehaji.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so what's the plot of that show and why did you like it?
Yeah, what is the plot?
It was a love story.
It was a love story, okay.
Okay, but it like...
Remember the last time you talked to us about a love story on the show? You talked about like how this Mazakon guy was like falling in love with his mother.
Ah, jitto anata ga suki datta. Yeah, it's a 1990s.
Is this show like that?
No, not at all, not at all, not at all. But actually, the guy never dated with nobody. But,
okay.
And then the girl, she didn't have a job. And then the guy, hired him as a...
Hired her as a girlfriend?
No, hired her as a housekeeper. And then because she didn't have a job, and they pretend marriage couple, and they business owner and...
Employee.
Can I do this? Because I need somebody to clean my house. Sure. And everybody's always yelling at me about not being married.
See, there's a precedent set there now. You can say right. It's just like that TV show.
What's the name of the TV show?
Nigehaji.
It's just like Nigehaji. It's the same thing, guys. It's the same thing. How much did she cost, you know? Was she cheap?
What was the hourly rate? Was that?
Maybe 28万4万.
That's easy. I could do that.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
Okay. I could do that. What did she do?
He's writing this down. He's actually written it down. But, unbelievable.
This is Tokyo prices, so I assume like where we are, it's a third of that.
Like 12, 10.
Let me tell you, it reflects a lot of Japanese problems. The girl is graduated from like, how do you say that in English?
Like master's degree.
Master's degree. But she couldn't get a job because she...
Were we just talking about this on the last show? That Japanese universities suck?
Yeah, but she couldn't get a job because people think that she's too smart to get a job.
Oh, she's too smart to get a job.
Yeah.
I've never met this person before. Like, who's too smart to get a job?
And because the Japanese guy didn't want to hire like smart girls in that company. Do you understand what I mean? So she couldn't get the job since she needed that job. Mm-hmm. So she asked him to hire him as a housekeeper.
Okay.
But, you know, people think that's a weird system, so they fake marriage.
Okay. Do they actually get married?
No, they didn't. Like, jijitsukon, like, people think that they're married, but they didn't.
But at the end of the story?
They fall in love and get married.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And in the real life, the actor and the actress got
just got married, right?
Yeah.
This was on the news the other day.
Was it too smart to get a job girl really, really beautiful?
Yeah, she was. She is.
Alex, how would you rate her?
She's kind of hot, yeah.
Okay, so this might be a possible path for me.
Yeah, we could do this.
Strategy for work Mitch. It out. Let's do this.
And then the guy's a singer in real life, right?
Yeah, yeah.
He's just got an annoying face.
Why?
I don't know. He's just a little, I don't know why he's an actor. You know what I mean?
He's a good actor.
Oh, he's tidy. Yeah, that's wrong. I'm sorry, guys. I shouldn't. Sorry.
But anyway, so like... There's a couple of different types of shows on Japanese TV.
He's
right?
got the stupid mushroom hair cut yeah, that they all have.
People like
he's
that now.
Cute.
She's all right, isn't she?
Yeah, she's all right. She's cute too.
Not my type.
Anyway. So dramas on Japanese TV, right?
Yeah.
Is it just me or are they all super overacted? I just don't get this.
No, dude, I'm looking for... Okay, so the funny thing is, like, we've decided this topic, and then today I was on Facebook, and JapanInsider.com actually has an article that came out, this was taped, but the day of this taping, why Japanese TV shows aren't popular outside Japan, and that's one of the things that they say.
Right, yeah.
Like, they pretend like they're acting, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's super hammy and...
What about Tom Cruise? He is acting like all the same character, no?
What? Okay, first of all, you don't watch an action movie for like really good like acting. And the other thing is what we're talking about is different. Like, okay, so if you go back to like the 1950s American TV shows like I Love Lucy, they're all talking like this when they're acting because their microphones are really far away.
Yeah.
Right? So they look like they're acting because it's basically like one generation removed from the theater stage to the television. Whereas Japanese people, like, for example, like... I'm angry. It's just so obvious that they're pretend acting.
No, the weird thing is, though, that you don't see this in Japanese movies.
The movies.
Japanese movie acting, the good movies, and Japanese TV acting is completely different.
Yeah.
So somebody who's done really well in a movie, done a really nuanced piece of acting that's brilliant, can be in a TV show, and they go back to sucking. And I don't know why...
But comedy dramas, I agree with that they are very overreacting. But some serious dramas, they are fine.
Even the TV police show ones, though.
It's really bad. And I'll give you an example of like what I'm talking about. Like, if you look at the top actors and actresses out there, like, you know, of the world stage, when they give like emotional, especially movies, like performances, it's so nuanced. Every little piece of what they're doing has been thought out. The cinematography is beautiful. It's just, it all comes together. In Japan, they'll just be like, boom, I'm angry.
No, that's
it's
not
like,
true.
And you're like,
true.
Yo, it is.
What is your last drama that you watched?
So, no,
How many dramas have you watched?
This is so true. I've seen lots of Japanese TV in the last 15 years because, you know, family will watch it.
Yeah.
So I'm sat there often on my phone doing something else. But it's very true. You know, it's super overacted. But I think the reason behind it, my theory... is that, you know, after a long day of work, they don't want something too real. And I've seen this with video games as well. Like, somebody playing, like, first-person shooters from the US and stuff like that versus the kind of anime-style, kind of Japanese RPG-type games or whatever. They all prefer that kind of cartoony look because they said it's too real, the other one, right? So they want fakeness.
So in this article, they talk about how what they do is instead of actually... So in good movies in the West, what they'll do is they'll get like real, like trained theatrical actors and actresses to play the main characters. Mm-hmm. And then like the cameos will be like popular idol people and whatever. Mm-hmm. In Japan, they'll get those people to play the main roles of the TV show or whatever. And actually, Josh was talking about this before, and it actually turns out to be true, is they'll find this like idol or popular person or singer or some person that they want to promote. It's all this is PR. Mm. So they want to promote this person to probably sell products or whatever. And then so they'll find, they'll make a show around this actor or actress, you know, whatever, this personality. And then like, they're crap actors. They're just not good at what they do.
Mm. So that Nigehaji.
Yeah.
the actress in that was in the Pocky adverts afterwards, and she does this dance in the TV show, like this cute kind of dance thing. Mm-hmm. And then she does this very similar dance in the Pocky commercial as well. It's the same person, right?
Right.
Yeah.
So, but different time.
But
she's not doing it in the show.
But similar timing, right? Around the same time, doing that kind of thing. So it's obviously, you know, built for those people, you know.
So the one thing that this article, I just want to go back to this, that came out just today, was talking about is that Japanese TV shows, if they're like using real people, just don't go anywhere abroad. But anime takes off.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And the big difference between the two is that anime doesn't have these like popular people that they're trying to promote in front of the camera. Mm-hmm. They're just going for a story of some sort. So you see a lot of good voice acting, and also it doesn't matter what the actors look like. It's just their voice, right? And then they can draw the you know, the scene in any way that they want. So that's why you see a lot of, like, if you look at Spirited Away, what is it? Sen Tochihiro no
Kamikakushi.
That movie won awards in America. I mean, it's a brilliant film. I mean, it doesn't really have too much of a story to it, but it's beautifully like illustrated, and the acting in it is superb. And when they translated it into English, they did a really good job. Disney helped produce it in America, you know, or I should say distribute it. But like, if you look at TV shows in Japan, I mean, like, have you any TV show gone to England that you can think of aside from Takeshi's Castle?
Takeshi's Castle, and that's it. A lot of some concepts went the other way, I think. Either started in Britain and went to Japan, or went from Japan to Britain. The concept of
you
the
guys
program.
Actually birthed a lot of American TV shows.
Yeah.
Like Top Gear, we stole that idea.
Top Gear, The Office.
The Office, yeah, we do.
What else?
The Office is from England.
The first season is an English, really bad TV show. Don't watch it, guys. It's horrible.
What do you mean?
The second, the real first season to the way long, I think the seventh season or something like that, it's all, like, they redid it in America with the same producer.
Mm. Yeah.
And the American one's way better.
It's not, but
it is too.
It's funny, The Office, you should mention it, but look at the reviews on Amazon or whatever in Japanese. It's hilarious.
It's not
awful.
Good.
It's like one star or less.
They don't get it.
Because it doesn't translate, that kind of humor. And they're not used to that downplayed style of acting, comic acting. So they don't know what it is.
Because it's not, like yelling at the camera.
But it doesn't make sense as well. You know, the jokes that are translated. You just read it and you're like, oh.
Also, one thing that really strikes me is, like, if you're a police officer and you're kind of old, your character is set in Japan.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, you play the role the way every other old police officer has ever played that role, ever.
But I heard that Japanese TV dramas are very popular among Asian countries, like Taiwan or Hong Kong or...
Is that true, guys? If you're at home and you're watching this, let us know. I know that Korean dramas are popular among Asian countries, but I don't know about Japanese ones.
Yeah. No, some countries they are, I think, yeah. The Tiger dramas, the historical dramas popular
that's a little
in
bit
some
different,
countries.
But they draw bank on that.
Yeah, they're expensive, yeah.
Like, I don't know. Like, so I used to watch Japanese TV show when I was a kid with me and my brothers, and we couldn't really understand what they were saying. Mm-hmm. So all we could really do is like see like the emotions that they're trying to convey through their acting, and we would just giggles the whole time.
Yeah,
we're like, you guys are so silly. Why do you act like this? Like, if I watch a French drama or something like that, I don't feel that way. I can't understand French.
Yeah.
But if I see a French drama, I'm like, I believe that. I believe it's real.
Hmm.
Yeah, there's a suspension of reality with it. I mean, like, the Tiger dramas come a little bit, I guess, from the Kabuki type tradition, which is all kind of over the top. And, you know, I'm performing, I'm acting, that kind of thing. So I guess there's that basis to it.
Yeah,
well.
But I guess Alex is right. We don't want on TV dramas too real.
Yeah.
It's a fake show. So we want to, it's an entertainment.
Okay, so let's not shit on the dramas too much. I mean, they're terrible. Don't watch them. But if you want to practice your Japanese and watch them.
How about Naked Director?
So that even then, you know what? Sorry. Better than Japanese normal TV, still not as good as a Western drama, a Western country's drama.
Mm.
Like, I'm sorry. Like, if you watch the acting, it's still like, boom. It's just like, oh, God, what are you doing?
Never people say poom, by the way.
But not in movies, though. I don't get why there's that difference. It's very strange.
I'm trying to think of a really good...
Mother. That's...
Mother was good. There's just the sad ones. Like, Daremo Shiranai was good.
Movies.
Go was good. These are just sad movies, is why.
Have you seen Arutemo? Arutemo, that's good.
No.
That's a good one. There's a lot of those. I like Yamada Yoji kind of movies as well. He's good. Kurosawa, obviously.
Why Kurosawa very popular among the world?
Kurosawa was popular because he copied American style of movie making and brought it to Japan.
Oh, okay.
So he watched John Ford movies and stuff like that. And at the time his movies first came out, they were criticized as being too Western by Japanese people. And then the kind of long shots, like 6 or 7 second long shots that he made, were then copied by Western movie makers when they made Western stories. So it's like a full circle.
Well, dude, art is supposed to copy other art.
Oh, yeah.
You're supposed to do that. Yeah. But, like, I'm trying to think of, like, what. Okay, so, Alex, what would be. Let's stop talking about TV for a second. What would be your, like, your favorite Japanese movie?
Movie?
Mine are all sad.
Is it Arutemo? Arutemo? I like that one. That was good. I liked Manbiki Kazoku. That was okay. It's good. I do like all the old Kurosawa. Kikujiro, that's a good movie.
Oh, Beato Takeshi.
Yeah, I love Beato Takeshi. So they're all like really, really well made. You know, the movie industry in Japan's great. I mean, there's a lot of shit movies too.
The ones that are well made are well made.
But, you know, the serious ones are good. There's a funny one called Happiness of the Katakuris, which is fucking weird. So
I have seen that. That is so weird.
Yeah. That's worth watching just for...
Dude, it's kind of almost a horror movie.
Yeah. You need to be on some serious drugs to get that.
Well, whoever made that was seriously on...
I mean, unequivocally, Japanese cinema is...
I don't
like
Japanese
really good.
Cinemas because they have a lot of like sick movie, like people die because of sick.
Oh yeah.
I don't like that. Maybe they want people to cry, make them cry.
Right.
I don't want to watch.
You just want to watch the.
So one of the things that I was pointing out before was the fact that if you watch the way that the trailer for. Baymax trailer for the American side and the Japanese side. It's the same movie. Okay. If you watch the American side, it's like, wah, boom. It's like a superhero movie. If you watch the Japanese trailer, it's like, oh, Hero's brother died. It's so like, and the soundtrack is different.
Really?
It's got AI's Hero or whatever that song is called. Mm. What's it called? It's all like Kando Tiki. It's all emotional on the Japanese side because y'all want to be sad in the theater. That's what you guys go there for.
Yeah.
But like the American side is just like, eat popcorn and have fun. Totally different. Nobody knows. It's again.
So how about like other genres of Japanese TV show? Because there's loads of other types as well.
Variety K? Like variety TV shows?
Variety with food. It's always another thing.
It's in the thing. It's like popular people. Wait, I'll find it. Continue. Sorry,
I always think it's like idiots eating shit, which annoys me intensely. So they'll get some like talento type in the studio and, you know, wheel out some food for them to taste. And then they'll do like a close-up shot of them shoveling it into the mouth and...
I don't know why it happens, but I like to watch them. Yeah.
I can't stand those, man.
It says it in this Japan Today article. It's like Japan only has three kinds of programs. Shows about celebrities, shows about food, shows about celebrities eating food.
Yeah.
Might be true.
And NHK. NHK's got some really cool TV shows, to be honest.
And it's got some really shit.
It's got some shit ones too, but the educational programs on NHK are brilliant. Have you seen Design A?
No.
Program?
Yeah, you mentioned
fucking
it before,
amazing.
Too.
Really?
Yeah. And then
they got the naked
that?
Director guy on NHK doing like some like science TV really? Show where he does it all creepy as hell the entire time.
He's creepy on the show.
But it's super funny. That's a good TV show. There's some creativity in Japanese TV that does happen sometimes.
Nihongo de Asobo.
That's a good show. Yeah.
Nomura Mansai, they got all the...
What about Eigo de Asobo?
That's good too. Both of them are good.
Yeah,
right, both of them are good.
Yeah. Mm. You know, there's those kind of shows as well. A lot of the kids' TV is really well made.
So the kids' TV is good because I think the directors have more freedom to do it.
Yeah.
And they're not trying to push celebrities and other crap with that.
Yeah.
Right?
Maybe they have sponsored to...
That's what I was talking about in this. It's all about the sponsorship and like the tight control of the media companies. Whereas in America, it's like, oh, you have this cool TV show. Let's put it out there.
You'll notice though, on the morning news, for example, they call it news. I don't like to call them news shows because they're not really, but the morning TV shows.
The morning announcer talking about stuff that they want to, you know, propagandize in the country.
So they'll do like a news report and it's always about stuff in Japan. Then it'll be like baseball player in America doing really well. Doesn't tell you anything about the rest of the league, just shots of him.
Right, that's
like,
true.
Japanese
baseball player in America.
Doing great. And then it'll go on a little bit more. And then it'll be like, here's some product that's just come out. Mm-hmm. And one of our reporters is going to go and try it out for you. And it's like an advert for 10 minutes. And they're not talking about, you know, world news or events that are happening elsewhere.
That's true.
In the evening news, they do the reverse where they talk about all this positive crap about Japan. And then they have like one negative story about Japan. And then they'll do like 15 negative stories about the other countries.
But recently,
that's not always true.
Not true.
Yeah. Recently. So recently, they're hitting, the government's getting a lot of shit, actually.
Mm. Yeah.
But
it was traditionally like that. So yeah. It's just like, never leave Japan. The whole world is scary.
No, it sounds like North Korea. Oops.
Is it okay? NHK, have you ever like talked to those people? I'm just kidding.
But, yeah. Like recently, there are a lot of shows with, you know, car accidents in China and shit like that.
No, like...
drunk person in Russia driving.
Okay, you know. So there's that TV show that like goes and visits Japanese wives who have married foreign men who live abroad.
Yeah.
They never pick the rich, like baller, like couple who lives in Paris and drives like Ferraris. No, they're like, this Japanese woman has married this man from this like little, you know, tribe in India, and they live a very like farmer life, and here she is pooping in a bucket.
Yeah.
And so it drives down the point.
That's true.
It makes it look like if you leave the country, your life is going to be hell. Don't leave. Marry a nice Japanese man and do your part to have more kids.
Yeah.
It's like the message from that TV show.
Well, there is the other kind of foreign TV show like Cool Japan and stuff like that, where they get a bunch of
foreign people to talk about how cool Japan is.
Studio, and it's like, yeah, I found out these great vending machines. They're amazing. Mm. Wish we had that in our country.
But every now and then they have like the debate shows where they have like all the different country people in there.
Yeah.
But they tell them before the show, don't say anything controversial, and then they just cut it out if they do.
Yeah.
That's like...
No, I will never go on one of those. If NHK, if you're interested,
he'll totally go out there. You'll have to edit heavily everything he says.
Yeah, I'll be a good boy in those ones.
Let's talk about we started talking about morning news. They have a clock in the corner of the TV, which I find amazing.
Is that not normal?
No.
No.
I mean, like some of the news organizations in America might have a tiny little clock in the corner.
Yeah.
But there's no like giant clock in the corner of this. Like it takes up like a good maybe 10% of the screen in the corner, upper right hand corner, where it just tells you the time in the morning. And it goes until like 9 o'clock in the morning or something like that.
What always freaked me out was Japanese TV studios. It's like it looks like a 12-year-old kid's designed it.
Well, you know, they don't have a lot of money, sir.
No, it's like glitter and. Insane
amount of colors.
Yeah,
there's a reason for that. They want to show Japanese TV does a lot of effort to make the especially the females look white. So all of the set that's behind them is generally designed to make the people in front seem whiter than they actually are.
Really?
Yes. That's why you'll never see like just a Mashiro background for like a completely white background, because like they don't want to seem any like hint of color in them. They want to be as white as possible. That's why they have those colorful backgrounds. And it looks more fun as well.
I can't slag off all variety shows, though, because there are some that
the
I find
funny. The
chocolate
one?
The one with, do you know, Matsuko Deluxe?
Mm. Yeah, and he's Matsuko Heya. Matsuko's Heya. Matsuko no Heya.
Matsuko no Shiranai Sekai?
That one's good.
That's funny.
Matsuko is funny.
Matsuko's really fucking funny. So
Matsuko's a...
that's my favorite show, too.
Matsuko is a giant, like, obese... I don't want to say he's a transvestite because he's not. He's like, he says he's a gay man, but he dresses up like a big woman all the time.
Yeah.
But anyway, he's from Kansai?
No, Tokyo.
Tokyo? Mm. He's really, really smart. Everything he says is like very, very intelligent. And he's got a very like iconic way of laughing where his entire like chin just oscillates like a wave.
It's very sharp wit though.
Yeah.
You know, it's not like, you know, a lot of Japanese comedy, there's a lot of slapstick and slapping each other and stupid jokes and stuff like that, or ipatsuge, you know, like a little song and dance that they do, which is funny for a year and then everybody gets sick of
it. No, it's not even a year, it's like 2 months and they get off the TV.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But, you know, he's really funny, she's really funny. I think it would be, wouldn't it?
He, because I think he identifies as a gay man. I think, if I'm wrong about that, don't know.
And then, you know, Beat Takeshi, who people abroad think is a serious director, but he's actually a comedian. You know, he's actually
old.
Funny. Yeah. But he's got a really sarcastic kind of sense of humor. Dark, really dark, you know.
So I want to bring this up because we have to talk about this. Is it chocolate? Show where like they go into a room, they put like these famous people in a room, and they have to like look around this room and figure out what objects are in the room are made out of chocolate. Mm. And the only way that they're allowed to tell if it's made out of chocolate is to bite it.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
they have this scene where they go up to it and they like take a bite out of what, like a door handle, for example. And if it's metal, they just like hurt their teeth. But yeah. if it's like chocolate, it's actually like breaks off and they can eat it. Yeah. It's chocolate.
How did you find that kind of show? I mean, you don't watch TV, right?
It's on TV.
I actually do watch some Japanese TV. I used to be on television, so I had to know what they were talking about, what was going on. Mm. So I used to watch a lot of Japanese TV. That's why I can tell you it's crap.
Because I don't know that.
You don't know the chocolate show?
I've seen that. Oh, no. Even I've seen this one, man.
And then there's another show called Kisumai Busaiku, which is actually a midnight show. Which I think is actually a pretty funny show, even though it's completely fake. They got these like boy idol group guys who like, there's six of them, I think, and they're on stage. And then they like give them, like they take them one by one into like this simulated situation with a girl. Mm-hmm. And it's like, you know, girl is angry because, you know, you didn't remember her birthday. How do you deal with it? And like all six of these guys do the different, their different like reactions to the situation. They try their best to like make the girl happy. While they're doing this, there's a live studio audience that has access to keyboards.
Right.
And they make comments about what he's doing while he's doing it.
Right.
And so they'll shoot up on screen and be like, oh, chou dasai, nani sore? And it's like, what the hell is this guy doing? That's so weird. And like, they just like shoot up on the screen while this like poor young male idol is doing his best to try to like win over this actress girl who's pretending to be his girlfriend. It's hilarious.
I mean, there's a lot of these like set up shows, dokkiri, surprise kind of shows and stuff like that. Candid camera type stuff. You know, they're very creative with the stupidity that they do. There's one where there's like a trap door you fall through into foam, a bath of foam, or whatever. And there was one that they did, I can't remember the setup, like I think they got somebody who was going to be an Olympic athlete or something like that. They had to run and press a button as fast as they possibly could. And the floor opened up and they fell in. And they were like, oh God, oh Christ, it's this show, whatever. They got out. And then they were walking them to the place where they could get a shower to get changed. And another one opened up and they fell in there. And then they got them out of there, took them, got them cleaned up, and asked them a question after it had finished. And while they were talking to them, another one opened up and they fell in again. So just that, you know.
The running joke.
Continuous, like, joke.
Well, isn't it like Waratari Ikenai, the downtown show that comes on at New Year's?
Yeah.
But what is it?
Nantukatsukai.
What is it called?
Gaki no Tsukai.
Gaki no Tsukai. Mm. It's that's like a fucking 4-hour show.
Yeah.
Every year.
That just goes on forever and ever, and it like has no plot, and they just keep thinking of the stupider and stupider things to do. And I laugh every time.
Mm. But the shows do go on for too long as well. And it's hard to tell when they start and finish, often find. You know, because they don't really have an outro or an intro or anything like that. So you're kind of like, what is this? Is it done now? What's going on?
Endless television.
Yeah. Mm. So, I mean, there's a lot of shit in between. But there are some real gems as well. But they're a little harder to find.
Mm. I like the show that we call Monitoring. But it's like, what would you do show? Like, idea is from maybe, you know, Western like countries.
Handed camera type.
Yeah, I like that.
I don't like that show because it's so repetitive, though. You know, it's the same thing every time.
I think it's NHK. It's like Nanaju Nijikan or something like that.
Oh, that's a good show. I like it.
Is it called Nanaju Nijikan?
72 hours.
Yeah, it's just they put a camera somewhere. Then they just watch something or someone for like 72 hours, so it was like 3 days.
It's like a documentary show.
Yeah, it's actually really interesting. That's interesting, but I'm pretty sure that they make that more interesting than it actually probably really is in real life. They probably cheat a little bit.
It's the magic of TV.
All right, guys, let's bring this episode also to a close. Let's answer the question, like, do we like Japanese TV? Is it shit? Is it awesome? What do we think? Natsuki?
I'm impressed, but I thought you don't watch JP, and I just you wanted to.
How many times do I have to impress you before you just stop being impressed? You know, it happens all the time. I'm kidding. Do you like Japanese TV?
I do.
100%.
I actually don't watch TV anymore.
Oh my God.
I just record the show that I want to watch. But I like it.
Alex, what would you say?
So I get home after a day of work, speaking Japanese, reading Japanese, writing Japanese. I don't want to watch any fucking Japanese TV.
Right, right.
But,
that's true.
There are nuggets in there that are good. Yeah. So for me, Japanese TV is a pile of shit with some golden nuggets.
That you gotta pull out of this
sweet corn sized nuggets of gold, which if you pull out and rinse off, then you can probably put in your mouth.
But pretty much understandable.
Where I'm going here. No, it's all right. There's some things I like, some things. Kids TV is great.
Kids TV is good. I agree with that.
Hate dramas. Hate variety TV shows. Apart from the really weird ones, which are funny. And Matsuko Deluxe is definitely worth watching. Yeah.
Josh, I actually want you to chime in on this because you watch with your girlfriend. You apparently watched some like shitty zombie TV show before.
Oh yeah, that was terrible.
It's like a copy of the American drama.
Yeah, it was like Walking Dead, but
crappier.
Like the Wish.com version of it.
The Wish.com version.
Yeah, I didn't watch it.
It was so bad.
What do you think about Japanese TV, Josh? What's your final comment on this?
Well, I would say I was actually surprised that you guys didn't really talk about anime that much.
Well, because I think anime is good.
Yeah. I would say, like, I like anime. Like, one of my favorite shows is Attack on Titan.
What is it?
Shingeki no Kyojin. It's actually one of the, like, highest rating, like, single episode shows in America. Or, like, in the top 10, like, 6 episodes are from that TV show. I like some anime. I'm not a big anime person, but I don't really like most
One
TV
Punch
shows.
Man. One Punch Man. He's great too.
I can't get into anime.
What is One Punch Man?
I think it's called One Punch Man.
I tried. What is it? Samurai Champloo? Is it?
That is an anime. Yeah.
I did like that because it was like hip hop and samurai, which are two things that I like.
Is that new anime?
No, it's old. Oh, okay. Yeah, it's pretty old.
It's like 20 or.
So what's your verdict on Japanese TV, Josh?
I think the dramas are bad. It's just kind of like mindless filler for the most part.
Thank you very much.
It's not your person. It's not an attack on you personally,
Natsuki. Thanks a lot, Natsuki.
I am presenting, you know, all of
You're representing,
Japan. Representing
all of Japan. Mm-hmm. Okay.
But like some of the game shows and stuff like that, I think are pretty funny.
Yeah.
So I would say like they're good shows and they're bad shows. Just like America too, like there are a ton of shows in America and I'd say 90% of them are crap.
I know, I was on one. Ooh. Ooh. I would agree with Josh on that. I'm gonna say that I think that the TV shows in Japan, especially the ones that you see after work, are really good at making you not think too hard and just enjoy your beer so you go back and be a nice little robot and work in your factory job the next day. I really think that's what they're for. I'm not even kidding. Don't think too hard, guys.
I forget that there's a lot of kind of crap TV shows in the UK as well, though. When I went back recently, I was watching, not recently, like a couple of years ago, but, you know, daytime TV, house and garden shows.
Actually, I like those shows.
I like them, but not like daytime TV version in the UK. Really suck. Antique shows, a lot of those.
So, okay, that's actually a good show in Japan. It's like the Antique Road show.
Yeah.
It's like that show, but it's like it's even funnier because the Japanese version, they make you like, it goes open the price, which doesn't make any sense.
Open the price. I've seen this.
But like they have like these, it's kind of sad, it's kind of heartbreaking sometimes because like when the like a grandmas and grandpas like bring this antique that they think is worth a lot of money. But what they do is like they have it and there's like this giant scoreboard behind them and it goes ichi ni san hyaku, whatever. It just keeps going like up in price. And so like you'll see like these old couple like holding this like antique that they think is worth $1 million and it turns out it's like worth $15.
Yeah.
And it like it's for everybody to see that. It's horrible. I forgot the name of the show.
Otakara Kantena.
I like that show, yeah. There's one about breaking into safes as well, isn't there?
What?
There's people who break into old safes and see what's inside.
That's what we need.
They draw it out for ages and then they get in it and it's like, yeah, it was empty. So, see you next week.
Reality TV shows.
Yeah.
No, but like, I mean, daytime TV in Japan is actually kind of, I would say, equivalent to daytime TV in America. It's kind of just like...
It's for housewives.
Yeah, it's for housewives, which I used to watch a lot when I was in high school because I was sick a lot, so I just watched that crap. I love the design TV shows that are like Discovery during like the daytime. This is how you make curtains. I'm like, oh really? That's all there was on because we didn't have anything else. We didn't have Netflix at that time.
You live in Las Vegas, right? And you're watching documentaries about curtain making.
It's like a show with like, I forgot what it was called, but it's like this bald gay guy who's like showing you how to design the inside of your house, and I'm just like, okay. It's on Discovery. I don't know. Anyway, I'd say it's the TV here is harmless. It's just like you go, you think you just come home because you're tired, you have your beer, ha ha ha, a couple times, and go to bed. It's weird.
But it's good that we have like now we have like Amazon
Prime,
Amazon Prime, Netflix,
Hulu.
Yeah, we have Disney a lot Plus. Of choices now.
Yeah, cool. I don't.
Not as many as American or British Netflix, which
God,
is kind of
annoying.
The library
here is so crap.
Yeah, it's so small.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, Disney Plus is also very, very small because they haven't translated it yet.
Right.
So. All right, guys, that's been our episode today. If you guys love Japanese TV and you think that me and Alex are wrong, let us know in a comment below. If you think that Natsuki is right with her representation of that Japanese TV is brilliant, you can leave us a comment below.
I didn't say brilliant.
You said it was all brilliant.
All of it, including the chocolate show that you don't know about. All right, guys, anyway, give us a thumbs up if you like this episode. Subscribe, make sure you turn on all notifications so that you can see when we post a new episode, which is every week. Otherwise, if you guys have any suggestions for topics for us or anything, just let us know in the comment section below. So this week's show. See you guys next week. Bye, everybody.
Bye.